David Gregory and Sam Stein in Washington. David Gregory, I guess I'll try and see the other side of the story. So help me out here. What is the logic of voting no? And let's show the names of all those who voted no as you speak. David.
You know, Mika, I've talked to Republicans on this who have tried to make the case for concerns about implementation of a background check. But I think the bottom line here is what we've been talking about, and it's pure politics. You know, it's not just the NRA, but it is indirectly the NRA's impact on folks in their home states. You know, Republicans were telling me yesterday, look, you should hear the people in my state who didn't want me to vote for cloture, who didn't want the debate to even move forward. These are folks who will absolutely vote on this issue in an election. Mm-hmm. One Republican senator said to me, yes, I know this is a 90% issue in the public, but will those 90% definitely vote on this issue? This person said, we'll see. We don't know that for sure. So I think that it's striking that the NRA's public position on all of this was to say, look, if we can do something to prevent the next Newtown, we ought to at least try. That's what Wayne LaPierre said right after the Newtown tragedy. And his idea was for a school safety, for armed guards. And indeed, a lot of state legislatures have taken that up. But when it came to extending something that the NRA had been for in the past, background checks, they said, no, no, this gets us down a slippery slope, and we're able to have the same impact that they've always had.
So, Reverend Al Sharpton, how do I say this as we look at these names and faces? Is Washington really filled with so many cowards, so many selfish, short-sighted politicians who really don't care about leading and only care about winning? How's that?
I think that's probably about hitting it on the head. They are political cowards. You're talking about people that in the face of Newtown, in the face of over 500 deaths of gun violence in Chicago, said, let's do nothing. And you know, Mika, I work on the ground with National Action Network. There's probably not a day someone doesn't come in one of our offices around the country victimized by gun violence or having lost a loved one. What do we tell young people now that we've been saying guns are wrong and don't glorify thug life? That what do we tell them when you have to have ID if you look young to get a beer, but you don't have to have ID to buy a gun? What are we supposed to go and tell them now? To have the courage that 44 members of the Senate didn't have, this is a disgraceful act, and I think that Joe Manchin and others should be given credit. But I think what it will do is it will, in many ways, energize a real movement toward 14. There will be a price to pay for
Tina
this.
Brown, my husband's an investigative reporter. He's been following the gun issue and the loopholes and all these other problems for years. He leaves for one day, goes undercover, comes home with 5 semi-automatic weapons. Bushmasters, whatever, lines them up in our house and takes pictures to show how easy it is to get guns. It is unbelievable. It is unbelievable that they won't make this process
just really
a little harder for people.
It is really incredible. But when you think about a woman, for instance, like Patricia Mache, who was in the gallery there, who was the woman who ran towards Jared Lee Loeffner, threw herself on him to stop him killing any more people after he killed 6 people and wounded Gabby Gifford, she has the kind of courage to do something like that. But this body of absolute cowardly worms hasn't even got the courage to vote against their own self-interest. And I think the only thing to say is, I mean, Senator Manchin said he's going to sit down with Heidi Heitkamp and he's going to bring her to Sweet Reason. Well, frankly, all you have to do is have money drive out money. No amount of Sweet Reason is going to convince Heidi Heitkamp.
It's too bad she couldn't just lead.
Exactly right. So you
That's
just have
shame.
To drive her out with money. And let's hope Mike Bloomberg can do that with his donations.
David.
Yeah, I mean, I think there's a little bit more to it than that, because I think that, you know, it's not just money driving out money. I think there has to be thought, first of all, how sustained will the fight be? And that is a question. The president promised to keep going. Manchin has promised to keep going. And I think that there's a real possibility that that could happen. But I also think how some of these fights get framed are important as well. If public opinion is really moving on the idea of additional gun restrictions, then it seems to me that the arguments have to be recalibrated as well. You know, why is it that mental health, which really does resonate as a problem in these shootings, why was that not made more public, more out in front in this debate when it's a critical part of any kind of remedy? The idea that everybody's got a role here. Why was there so much emphasis on an assault weapons ban and a magazine ban, efforts that were tried before, succeeded before, but barely, and that's when Democrats controlled the House. So I think that that's something that needs to be looked at tactically if you're going to sort of harness how public opinion could be moving.
Yeah, I just want to add one thing, because I think what we're missing sort of the big picture issue here, which is that our political system jolts only for massive events. And a couple statistics bring that to mind. You know, in 2011, there were 17 U.S. citizens killed in terrorist attacks. Contrast that to about 4,700 who were killed in workplace incidents and 31,000 plus who were killed by gun violence. These are incidents that are happening right now around us. We tend to react very viscerally to the terrorist attacks, even though they cause the least amount of death. And that's obviously for a reason. They're tragic events in their own right. But we don't have a system that's geared toward dealing with the problem that's there every day, day in and day out, and that's workplace tragedies and gun-related tragedies.
All right. Our thanks to David Gregory, Tina Brown, Al Sharpton. Coming up next, we'll have the latest from the town of West Texas, where a massive explosion at a fertilizer plant has left multiple dead and many, many more injured. More Morning Joe when we come back.